Here we go again, sitting around playing video games. Damn, it's so hard to be a gamer when you want to create something meaningful and productive. I just think way too much about video games. Probably I should develop a game. I mean, I could. I'm a web developer, so I'm pretty sure I could code something cool. But I don't know anything about game engines or game design. Nah, it's nothing for me. I would have to learn so much new things, and it would take hours and hours and hours and hours.
Do it! Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow, so just
Whoa,
do
okay,
it.
Shia, I will give it a try.
Come true!
So let's Google how to develop games. Huh, Unity game engine looks like an easy game engine where it could use C# and easily develop some games. Unity, I like T. I should make one. Okay, let's check this out. First step, make some T. Check. Second step, install Unity. Check. Now to the final step. I have to develop some games. How hard could that be? Ooh, finally, let's start my first game. Hey guys, my name is Timo and welcome to Unity, where I will show you my journey of becoming a game developer while drinking some tea. In the last few years, I mainly developed web applications, but game development interested me since I was playing video games as a child. From this moment, I will go down this road and give you a continuous progress how I developed this new skill, what I will learn on this way, and which games I want to develop in the next few years. Now we have talked enough. Let's get started with the most important step. The idea. I want to build a top-down 2D pixel art life sim MMO. This game will be inspired by games like Sims, Animal Crossing, and GTA. I really love the idea of an open world where you can meet other players and do a lot of things together within a life sim game. I also love the aspect of user-generated content, especially in video games, because it feels like you have a real impact in the digital world if you can create things and share things with other players. I always think about the clothes designs in Animal Crossing, where players can design own designs for their clothes, like the shirts. When Animal Crossing Wild World was released in 2005, they also had this feature to visit the town of other players through the internet. That leads to players organizing a website to sell and buy items from other players. The website was called nukebay.com, which was just a combined wording for Nuke, the shop owner in Animal Crossing, and eBay. And damn, it was just like eBay with in-game money, where you could bid on auctions and sell your items, then meet up with the players from all over the world and connect with each other. I mean, how cool was that? Nukebay was created in 2006. Who put that effort into it? Well, this was a unique gaming experience of my childhood. And it shows that a community bringing value to a game is in fact a great idea. For my game, this should be supported with systems where players can create own stuff and connect to each other easily. So to build this 2D life sim MMO, I really should start to define a MVP. A MVP is not just the most valuable player in a video game, it also stands for the minimum valuable product and it defines what it really needs. It's the answer to the question, what are the core features of your product or game? And it let us think about what are the important things I should implement first to make a game that is actually fun to the player. For me, these are the key features I want to implement. First, I want a system of needs and desire. When I played Sims as a child, I always liked the tension of a never-ending to-do list of needs where you have to build an intuition of how to manage these needs of your character. I think it's a very fun system to manage some basic needs of your character, and I want something like this in my game. The next system I want is a housing system, where you can customize your home, change all the furniture in your home to make it your own digital room. Besides that, a skill system is a must-have for this game. I want to implement skills like cooking, programming, and reading to give the player a possibility to improve and develop their character and transform to something special. And I really love the idea of an open world where players can interact with the world in different ways based on their skills and uniqueness. Besides this, the multiplayer aspect is very important for me. I love it, I want it, and it seems like a big challenge. Because whatever you read about building a multiplayer in Unity, people just call it the ultimate challenge for beginning game developers. These four aspects are the key elements of my MVP. When I reach this point, I can expand the world, the skills, and the user-generated content editors as long as I need. But the game will already be fun with this basic setup, and this leads us to the last step, create. Now I know what I really want to develop, and I can start building my game from scratch. I hope you will join me on this journey. I would love to hear your opinion about the game concept and this channel. So please let me know in the comments and
see you at the next team.
Do it! Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come true!